first book that I read. So after the last book goal that I did say that I wanted to choose between Happy Place and Fourth Wing. Yeah, I didn't choose any of them. I ended up picking up Reckless by Elsie Silver. Decided to read you know, just even science in general, but just it deals with like sexism and stuff, and how, you know, women back then weren't taken seriously in important work like this. They were just expected to be a housewife, cook, clean, and have kids. And I loved her character because she was determined to change that mindset, you know, take women more seriously. But she ends up, she just ends up working as a cooking show host on a TV show, and she basically incorporates all of her science or chemistry knowledge into the show rather than making it a typical cooking show. So it's more like a chemistry show, but she's cooking, but she's teaching all these women who are watching her show chemistry, and you know, there's a lot more you can, you're capable of, and you can learn, and you can do, and it's inspiring. It is inspiring. It's a good book. I really enjoyed the concept of it. Her character was a little bit irritating at times, but not in a bad way. But yeah, I really liked it. I am excited to watch the TV show though now. Now that I finished the book, I really want to watch the TV show. Think maybe if I listened to the audiobook, would I have enjoyed it a little bit more? I did enjoy it, but would I have enjoyed it more? Would I have given it a 4.5? I don't know, maybe. But the only reason why I'm saying it's not a 5-star is because I didn't feel like, oh my god, I can't wait to get back to this book. I didn't have that feeling, honestly. But like I said, it's not a slow book at all. I just felt like when I started it, it was going a bit slower for me, but that's just me. That could just be that at the time, like I said, I wasn't in the mood for it. So okay. Oh, I didn't, oh, and I love this as well, I forgot to mention. I absolutely love how this book looks. In fact, let me just read a little bit here. It's the early 1960s, and our all male team at Hastings Research Institute take a very unscientific view of equality, except for one, Calvin Evans, the lonely, brilliant Nobel Prize nominated grudge holder who falls in love of all things with her mind. True chemistry results. So yeah, I forgot to mention there is a love story in this as well, but I wouldn't say that's like the center of the book, in my opinion. Maybe I read that wrong, but I wouldn't say it was. But yeah, I did enjoy Lessons in Chemistry, and I'm looking forward to watching the show. It's just on triggers. Okay, so the next, so like I said, when I put this book down, I turned to an audiobook, and I bought Just for the Summer. Yeah. This was like 280 and start a life with Keitha, so his love, and like the person he fell in love with, and then to give her hope. That was inspiring, because when you read this, you're like, how are you ever gonna get back to a normal life after this? That's all I'm gonna say. Yeah, it's quite, it's sad. It's sad, but it's such an inspiring and a great story, and this is actually now made into a TV series as well, so I'm really excited to watch that and, you know, see how the book translates on screen. But yeah, 5 stars from me. I would say the writing is pretty simple, simplistic. It's nothing, it's easy to read, you'll get through it pretty quickly. Yeah, it's, I mean, it's not very descriptive. I guess it's not very descriptive. Like I said, it's quite simplistic, the book, the way it's written, but that's fine. That didn't bother me, because this is someone, you know, this is someone kind of telling their story of their experience, so I don't really care how the book's written. Do you know what I mean? That's not really what the most important thing is. But yeah, it's quite, a bit of an eye-opener as to what was going on at that time in life. Yeah, but absolutely enjoyed this book so much, The Death Tourist of Auschwitz, and again, I liked that this was something that was completely different to the other books that I was reading, so I did have a good variety, actually, over the last couple of months. I've had a good variety of books. Someone did request for me to do a book triggers video, like just book triggers, nothing else. I already had that on my list, so I will hopefully be doing that soon. I'm sorry if I haven't done enough triggers and I've been rambling on too much. But yeah. So I, like I said, I took this on holiday with me, so I read it on the flight there and the flight back. I also took Happy Place by Emily Henry with me, and we had 1 or 2 days by the pool on holiday, but that was it. And I did start the book. I think I'm a third way through it, maybe. But I'm gonna continue that one now as well. I'm excited. My question.